brothers, sisters, and of course, respected brothers and sisters, and remaining brothers, sisters, particularly those young students now who got this associate degree. You are the future of the world, and in this case, future of India. So I usually make sort of the distinction, generational 20th century. We hear generation of 20th century. Now you, generation of 21st century. Now what kind of 20th century is too much violence, war. It seems 20th century belongs to army people. So, you see, now big question, that immense violence, including use nuclear weapon, really brought better world? I think the answer is no. According to some historian, about 200 million of people killed through these violence, including civil war. Now we witness now today, that no matter how sincere motivation and also the right goal, once you use the military forces, then always also the unpredictable consequences. So now, this 21st century must build a century of peace. And peace not through prayer, but through action. I usually describe this 21st century should be century of dialogue. Differences always there, but in order to face these differences, use force. Is once you committed violence, then counter violence, then change reaction. So there, now for example, Iraq war during President Bush. I know him since my first sort of meeting with President Bush. On a human level, very nice person. Some sort of president, sometimes I feel, there's too much formality. So it's difficult come to closer. But Mr. Bush, first meeting, we immediately come to close. As a human level, very nice person. However, Iraq, sort of crisis after the September 11th event. Motivation is good. The goal is to bring democracy in Iraq. But his method? Use force. So immediately after September 11th tragedy happened, I wrote a letter to President Bush, since we know each other very well. So I express my condolence and my prayer At the same time, I express, I wish, challenge this should follow non-violent way. I hope, I wrote. Then, he used United States force. So, now we can see. Because of that, Sarasvati used force. I think almost whole Arab world, something, different attitude. So now Sarasvati is so-called the terrorist. And I feel that wrong policy also, I feel, one factor to increase hatred towards America. So, the violence, I don't know, in front of General Army, you may get some sort of satisfaction. Eliminate 1,000, 10,000 enemy soldier, you feel proud. These people, not just one, their family, their children's children. Once their father killed, some feeling remain in their children's children. So now only way is it to create a peaceful world. We must develop willpower, no matter what complicated situation. Try to solve that through dialogue. Respect their view or their interest. That's the only way. Now 7 billion human beings on this planet. So different views always there. But then, if you use show of force, no good. And you mentioned produce more weapon. No, American president also now. This is also the thinking more production of more weapon, including nuclear weapon. I totally disagree. No, that's not right. I think because of American side, you see, at least showing the increase military weapon. So Russian side, President Putin also now saying the number of awful, sort of powerful nuclear weapon, Russia. And even small country, North Korea. If this situation goes continuously, this 21st century will be, I think, a century of disaster. Now question is, 7 billion human beings, what happiness? No one is there risk of their own life and suffering. No. And then further to the question, basic human nature, what's the basic human nature? Now scientists, so they say basic human nature is more compassionate. The reason to young children, 5 months, 6 months old, show them some positive sort of attitude, two children play together with smile. And that picture shows to that young infant child smiling. And then the two children, negative attitude one another. That picture shows that infant child express unhappy sort of expression. And then our own experience, constant anger, constant fear, is actually eating our immune system. There's medical scientists about this. And calm mind is very good for our health. Then, 7 million human beings, when they start their life under the full of love, compassion, mainly from one mother. Those 7 million human beings, including today's troublemaker, they also come that way. They are human beings. They come from their mother. So basic human nature is more compassionate. So that's a hopeful sign. If our basic nature is anger, then no hope. But the basic nature is more compassionate. Therefore, now, time come. Education should help to further nurture these basic human values. Here, I have criticism. Existing so-called modern education is oriented about material value. Obviously, existing education system in this country, introduced by Britisher, a European country, I think perhaps around 200 years ago, before that, I think monastery or nunnery carried the center of education. Then science and the technology gradually developed. And then the education carrying monastery or nunnery not sufficient, not adequate. So separate education institutions started. So at that time, moral ethics, these carried by monasteries or nunneries. So newly developed sort of technology, science, these then need separate education institution. Perhaps at that time, more or less, quite sufficient balance. Now today, effect to the public from religion limited. We can see in Europe, in America, a big monastery, nunnery, now empty. So therefore, now education, the institution alone, should take full responsibility, not only brain development, but development of warm-heartedness. So now here, India's thousand-year tradition, secular, not necessarily religious, sort of minded. Without religion, India's constitution itself based on secular. So, according to Indian understanding, secular means respect all religions. Now, Jammu Kashmir here is clearly demonstrated, Buddhist, Muslim, Christian, Hindus, we live together. So India as a whole, I think, religious harmony is really marvelous. India is the only example country where all different religious traditions can live together. So, this 1,000-year-old India's tradition of ahimsa and secular, mainly now here, secular, respect all religion, and also respect non-believer. That is something very unique. Today's world, out of 7 billion, 1 billion non-believer. So, the India's thinking tradition, secular, I think very relevant to today's world. And with secular, and then another sort of India's concept, ahimsa. Ahimsa means action of karuna. So ahimsa, karuna must go together. So before Buddha come, India already have the tradition of ahimsa or karuna. And then the secular concept. So now today, of course, India size also, you see, population also now over billion population. But the real India's strength is India's 1,000-year-old India's cultural heritage tradition. I feel India is only nation who can combine modern education that bring us physical comfort, ancient Indian knowledge, shamatha, vipassana, including yoga, these bring us inner comfort, inner peace. So you can combine these two things. So ancient Indian knowledge, not only just ancient one, but very relevant to today's world. In order to achieve the peaceful 21st century, India's 1,000-year-old tradition is very, very relevant. Now, just for a few days, I have serious discussion with modern scientists and educationists, mainly from America and some European countries like that. So this kind of meeting, over now 30 years, I have serious discussion. Then it becomes very clear the ancient Indian knowledge is really very relevant to today's world. In many schools in America, now they start education about compassion, education about non-violence. So research, they say, obvious research. Like, I think, at least as far as I know, two cities. One city, name of city of kindness. Another city of compassion. And within the city, there's some program about kindness and compassion. As a result, children in these cities, much more peaceful. So they already demonstrated all their knowledge actually come from India. I myself consider student of ancient Indian thought. Since 8th century, Buddha Dharma, although 7th century, but not very detailedly, 8th century, Tibetan Emperor Chisungdezen invited Shanta Rakshita from Nalanda. 8th century, around that, the Nalanda then picked up, highly developed. So Nalanda tradition, see, not just one sort of monastery or one sort of institution of monk, no. Nalanda institution, I think at that time, truly university, logic. I myself like thousands young monk student, 6-7 year old, we study logic. Parmana. And we have certain very important text like Parmana Vartika Karika. We learn by heart, memorized, and then each word explain. Then use extensively debate. So through that way, our mind become quite sharp. Not just faith. Oh, faith, good, but not much helpful to further increase our intelligence. Logic, in order to carry logical approach, skepticism is important. You don't agree easily. You must raise question, why? Buddha himself, you see, expressed, all my follower should not accept my teaching out of faith, but out of investigation and experiment. Therefore, some Nalanda master actually rejected Buddha's own teaching. If you accept this teaching literally, it goes against this reason, that reason. So we should reject that. So that's Nalanda tradition. 8th century, Shankarakshita brought the Nalanda tradition to Tibet. So since then, I think we Tibetan sincerely follow his instruction, not just blind faith. Investigation. Now that trend, that way of training, I myself, no single class I attend modern education. My broken English around, I think, in 50s, I said because of that. Sosujani. Study by myself. Therefore, now so many decades passed, but still my English, very, very broken English. Okay, very useful. So I never attend school or university about science or this modern education. But when we sit together with professors, many universities in America or Europe, when we discuss, our brain quite useful. You know, sometimes you see when the scholars in different fields, cosmology, neurobiology, and physics, particularly quantum physics, and psychology, in these fields, these common subjects, so we discuss. So when they make presentation, their own profession field, with full confidence, when we listen, oh, there are some contradiction here and there. So then, with respect and very gently raise some question, then these professor, they say, oh, I have to think more seriously. So this is a Nalanda tradition, India's tradition. All our knowledge come from India. I always describe India. Historically, our guru, our teacher, we are chela. So I usually describe we not only just a chela, but also quite a reliable chela. In Guru's own land, now this knowledge now reach nirvana. This knowledge now disappear. Over 1,000 years, we get this knowledge. So, it proved we are quite a reliable channel of India. So now I really feel today's world, modern education is concerned, highly developed, but not help to reduce violence, to bring peace to the world. The modern education failed because modern education oriented about material value. Peace related here. Inner peace there, peace comes. Here, full of hatred, full of serious sorrow because of the competition and anger. Peace impossible. So peace, we need peace. Even ecology also need peace. Now global warming truly become more serious. So such period, I think ancient Indian knowledge tackle our emotion is very, very important. Now these days, I'm telling the, taking care about our health, taking care about our physical, hygiene of physical, Now we need hygiene of emotion, we need. The world, I think, really passing through crisis of emotion, including many leaders, because of too much of crisis in emotion. So they themselves, not a happy person, their family, not necessarily happy. So in order to develop happy world, first, happy family, that happy individual. Happy individual, you may be billionaire, but without the knowing how to tackle our emotion, the individual will not be happy person. Clear. Now, in this respect, India really has great potential. Now, hygiene of emotion, this country has the knowledge how to tackle, no other country. Of course, I respect all religions. Those theistic religions, God, creator, wonderful. There are many people from that faith really develop a wonderful, sensible, nice human being. But there are not much use human intelligence, just faith. This country, Sangha philosophy, Jain philosophy, Buddhist philosophy, no concept of creator, so rather self-creation. Therefore, before Buddha come, already in this country, the tradition of Shamana, tradition of Vipassana, already there. So, you see, use human intelligence in maximum way. Try to investigate. That's why logic becomes very important. So this is an Indian tradition. Now modern India, too much westernized. Of course, I really admire Western civilization, Western intellectual people. I really appreciate. But I think, compare ancient Indians of thinking, I think this country truly developed the method to tackle our emotion. Now that must revive in this country. If you, the generation of the 21st century, if you make some effort with vision, with determination, willpower, then I think India can be, besides material development, I think inside Sabha City, because of the knowledge and peace inside. If you truly come, then because of the population, India really can make significant contribution for world peace and a happy world. So you, a younger generation, or generation of 21st century, please think seriously and should recognize great potential of this country. The modern education must combine traditional Indian knowledge, not just a puja or some ritual, not that. Serious study about our mind, about our emotion. That's very, very important. Should take as a secularism or academic subject and secularly, whether believer or non-believer, doesn't matter. These are our common sort of knowledge, something related with our common people. So, please, the young Indian, now you should think more seriously, with more holistic attitude, not just admire some particular thing you admire. No, more holistic way. Okay. That's what I want to share with you as a student of ancient Indian master. So I want to share that to you. Otherwise, in the modern field, in the military or your education field, you have some professions. I have nothing to say. Thank you. Firstly, I want to express my deep congratulations to those young students who now Kasa. Dedicated Kasa degrees. So now you start real life, not easy. You should not expect our life will be easier. No. Life complicated. And such a situation, willpower is very important. In order to keep willpower, you should be honest, truthful. Then your life can carry transparency. If deep inside fear, doubt, suspicion, that's the greatest obstacle about determination. Willpower, without willpower, without determination, without optimistic attitude, your life, even small problem, then you really face difficult to handle. But determination, willpower, and keep your mind calm and utilize your intelligence maximum way. For that, look holistically, holistically, then any problem can solve. So, determination, willpower, very important. For that, honest, truthful, very important. Too much cunning. Sometimes education brings us more clever, more cleverness, more cunning. Very harmful, deep inside. Your fear, distrust. So honest, truthful is really the basis of self-confidence. Without self-confidence, and then difficult to determine our willpower. Okay, so I just want to share with you. Now, I am now generation of the 20th century. Now my age, now nearly 83, now not much years come. But you now have to sort of face remaining 21st century. If you start work effort with vision, realistic vision and effort, you will see this 24, remaining 21st century can be more happier, peaceful century. We will see, I think we may lay us in heaven. So now, please, of course, our brothers and sisters, home, and particularly younger brothers and sisters, please think more seriously. That's all. Thank you.